Do you feel that DICT gave them preferential treatment? Because Adel Tamano did issue a statement and say that they followed the rules in the most stringent manner. And that's what he had said, of course. So what?
I raise an issue on the due diligence of the NTC, because a simple reading of the franchise grant would immediately raise the red flag. Just 25-year franchise, 1998, it will expire in 2023. What will happen after 2023? Did they secure the permission? I discovered this. I just looking at the general information sheet filed by Mislatel in the SEC. I already had questions when I saw their GIS to have new stockholders. Did they secure the consent? So these are standard inquiries that you make. And their failure of the NTC.
So the NTC did not do its homework.
To my judgment, they failed to exercise the necessary diligence needed in order to grant the franchise.
Okay. Now, DICT Acting Secretary Rio also asks Congress to change the provisions in granting franchises, because he claims it's hard for telcos now to roll out and become operational. Congress has to make complying easier.
I don't know. It has been there. This requirement has been there. And you have, you have 101 companies, ABS-CBN. Are they under the same conditions? Yes. GMA, other states, are they imposed in the same conditions? Yes. Are they compliant? Obviously, yes. So I do not know what General Rio is talking about, that we must relax this. Remember that this grant of franchise is to the public interest. This is a privilege